This is the iTIG 3 Model C. The Model C includes milli-ohm winding resistance, MegOhm or insulation resistance measurements, DC Hipot, and the surge test. Options include micro-ohm winding resistance, capacitance, inductance, impedance or CLZ measurements. That also includes the RIC test, rotor influence check, advanced multi-coil test feature and reporting, and partial discharge measurements. Today we're testing a small 2 horsepower 460 volt stator. There are no known issues with this guy, but let's see if we can prove that. Click start. We'll get to our customer directory or motor database. We have already entered in the information for the motor we're testing. So if you look under the motor ID column, we have it listed right here. Click the row containing your motor ID or serial number. We now get our motor identification, operating voltage, and nameplate information. We want to start a new test record, so we're going to click test. We're now in test mode, and we will work our way from left to right along the tabs. We're actually on the last tab here, the test summary screen. We can enter in a test description. We'd like to enter in just a quick description of what we're testing on, in this case, a stator. You can use the tab button to scroll down the list. You can enter in a test stage. That might be a used incoming or a fresh rewind that's going out. We actually have some pre-programmed profiles already in the tester. These can be changed to be in line with your test requirements or your test, your customer's requirements. For this example, we're just going to select a incoming used motor. Operator, just like to add my initials. Next step would be to go to the setup screen in the bottom left corner. At the top here, you'll see your Hipot and surge test voltage formulas. They default to 2 times the operating voltage plus 1000, and then there's this extra multiplier if you want to derate the test voltage. This formula, or these two formulas, are associated with the test profile, the test stage we selected on the previous screen. If you change your mind, you can always click the function button here and select a different test stage if you selected the wrong one or you disagree with the voltage. You can also change anything in the voltage formula. So if you want to test to 2000 volts instead, go ahead and enter that in. Next step here would be to enter in the humidity and winding temperature. We're in Colorado. It's a nice dry day. Let's say 35% humidity. The winding temperature, this is, as it states, the winding temperature, not the ambient temperature. In this case, the motor has been sitting in our warehouse overnight, so it's essentially at room temperature. So I'm gonna say 22 degrees. Next step here, auto mode and limits setup. MegOhm profile and test voltage. We're at 500 volts for the MegOhm. That's good for this low voltage application. Using the drop-down menu here, we can select if you want to do a DAR, so that's a dielectric absorption ratio, or if you want to do a PI measurement with a DAR, or just a 1 minute insulation resistance measurement. We're going to select to do a DAR in this case. Similar with the Hipot, you can use the drop-down menu to select either a 1 point Hipot, which we're at right now, that's a 1 minute test, or you can do a 5 point or 10 point step test or a ramp test. These things are really, really nice for larger or higher voltage applications, especially if you want to do a PI. You don't want to sit there, crank up the voltage, wait for it, make the measurements along the way, and then shut it off. With the C model, this is done automatically. So let's select a 1 point Hipot. On the right hand side, we have our limits. That's the pass fail criteria. I'm just going to leave those at the default. Same motor test configuration. It means that this is now stored for this motor ID. Next time you come back to test it, no setup required. Exit setup. And we're ready to start testing. First on the list here is winding resistance. So we will need our low voltage lead set. The low voltage lead set connects to the RCLC port. So open it up, connect it like so. And the leads are marked with 1, 2, and 3 to correspond with phase 1, 2, and 3. So we'll connect it here. Lead 1 to phase 1, lead 2 to phase 2, lead 3 to phase 3. Make sure that your connections are good. This is a high precision measurement. So if you have any resistive connections, that will throw off our test here. Okay, so now we're ready to do the winding resistance measurement. We can simply just click the star coil symbol. The tester will now complete the measurement from lead 1 to 2, 2 to 3, 3 to 1, and calculate our max delta R. In this case, it turned out to be 0.1%. That's very good. And we're now ready to move on to the MegOhm measurement. So with the MegOhm measurement, we will need our high voltage leads. So we'll disconnect the low voltage lead set from the motor. You can leave it connected to the tester, that's fine. Put it back here and grab the high voltage lead set. Similar to the low voltage leads, these are labeled 1, 2, and 3. So lead 1 to phase 1. Lead 2 to phase 2, and lead 3 to phase 3. And don't forget to connect the ground clip to the frame of the motor. It needs to be connected to an unpainted clean surface. We have a nice bolt here we can connect it to, like so. And we're now ready to start our high voltage test series. Okay. First up is our MegOhm measurement, or insulation resistance. Since this is the automated C model, we can click auto mode. It will show us down here in the bottom left corner what the test profile is. It's a DAR, which is what we told it to do. We'll click the red button, and the tester will automatically increase the voltage to 500 volts, which is what we set it to do, and sit there for a total of 60 seconds in this case. It will make a measurement at 30 seconds and at 60 seconds and calculate the absorption ratio. At the conclusion of the 60 seconds, the tester will automatically de-energize. It will display our dielectric absorption ratio, in this case 1.85. The leakage current is in the top right corner here is very low. We're in 2 nanoamp range here. Calculated the raw MegOhm number and then the corrected MegOhm number. The corrected MegOhm at 40 degrees is the MegOhm measurement or MegOhm reading we use for the pass-fail criteria. So this motor tested fine. Nothing obviously wrong here. Very low leakage currents, very high MegOhm readings. We're safe to move on to the high voltage testing. Next up is the Hipot test. Similar to the MegOhm or insulation resistance, we'll use our auto mode profile here. In this case, we're going to do a 1-point Hipot. So that's just a 1-minute test. The instrument will ramp it up to 1920 volts, sit there for a minute, shut off. If we selected a step test, or a ramp test, it would complete that automatically as well. So press the red button, and it will now ramp up the voltage to our design test voltage, sit there for the full minute, and then de-energize. Okay, so we have concluded the Hipot test and the MegOhm test. Both turn out good. Very low leakages at the 1920 volts as well. One thing to mention here is that these tests can be done manually. if you prefer to do it so. In that case, you would just compress the red button and use the silver dial to increase or decrease the voltage. When you're satisfied with your results, press the red button again. This will automatically discharge the windings and you're ready to move on. Okay, let's do the next thing on the list here. That would be the surge test. Lead one is automatically highlighted first. This is the phase where we have the instrument set the time base and voltage scale. So when we arm the instrument here, press the red button, it will automatically go through the process of finding the correct oscilloscope settings and drive the voltage to our design test voltage. It's already done, so we'll select phase two or lead two, arm the instrument, press the button. Now it's really quick. And similar phase three, press the button, and we're done. As you can tell, we have three phases very nice and neatly overlapped. It's hard to tell that there are three surge waveforms here. At the top, you get your percent wave differences. The largest one here was between 2 and 3, so that would be the red and yellow traces that you can barely see. That's 2.5%. It's very nice and low. And otherwise, in other words, this motor is testing fine. No problems there. So you can go to the last tab here, the test summary screen. All pass, all green. The motor is good. We're safe to move on. Click the folder button to exit out of test mode. Everything is automatically stored. There's no save operation. We can now go and say view print pass test. We get a full record of every test done to this motor ID or a serial number. We did this top row here just now. You can say display test if you want to go back and look at the screens that we just went through, or you can say print report. Print report, you have some options to include a cover page, equipment information, and so on. Say print, and the tester will automatically generate a nice pre-formatted PDF report stored on the tester. The end of the day, folder all the way back out to your motor database, insert a USB flash drive, sync files with flash drive, and now you can look at those PDF reports on your PC, or you can take the raw data and generate new reports using TR Pro, which is included with the purchase of the tester.